As of February 19th of 2023, there are 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting across 7 continents, including Antarctica, where both the Mount Erebus and Mount Michael volcanoes are emitting volcanic rock. With this being said, this week's top volcano-related news stories all involve volcanoes which are not actively erupting. In Indonesia, the Tangkuban Parahu volcano was the site of an observed orange glow on February 9th, yet it is not considered to be erupting and its alert level was not raised. To find out why, stay tuned. And, in what is this week's top and most requested story, unusual activity occurred at the Askja Volcano in Iceland. For context, the Askja Volcano is in the central eastern section of Iceland where it consists of what was once a largely subglacial volcano that now has 3 overlapping large calderas, the last of which formed in a powerful explosive eruption in 1875. This eruption formed a 4.7-kilometer or 2.9-mile-wide caldera which is now filled with a body of water known as Askja Lake. Due to the location of this lake and the generally cold temperatures of the region, the lake consistently freezes over and stays frozen between the months of December to mid or late May. That is, unless the crater lake experiences increased heating due to volcanic activity, perhaps due to increased submarine fumarole temperatures, a new influx of hot spring water, or an increased temperature at local hot springs. One or more of these may have occurred at Askja's Askja Lake, which suspiciously began rapidly melting 3 months earlier than was supposed to, and this was not due to high temperatures as the region is still consistently below freezing. Even more suspicious was the section of the lake which began melting first just so happened to be the exact coordinates closest to the epicenter of ongoing long-term magmatic uplift, which has now totaled 51 centimeters that has been occurring at Askja since August of 2021 due to an intruding body of magma at a depth of 2 kilometers. This melting started around February 5th of 2023, and the hole it produced in the lake has continually increased in size until it covered much of the lake on February 18th. While scientific sensors have been placed in the lake to learn more, there has surprisingly not been any notable increase of seismic or other volcanic activity beyond already elevated levels which have remained elevated since August of 2021, which sensors can measure so far. I want to also note that a similar event occurred during February of 2012 and that did not result in a volcanic eruption. One possibility is that unusually strong winds caused the ice to break, which then shifted to a smaller section of the lake. While it is still unclear what, if anything, is occurring in Askja, scientists are continuing to keep a close eye on the volcano. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, an orange glow was observed at the Tangkuban Parahu volcano on the island of Java on February 9th, yet it was not considered to be erupting. This is despite the fact that the glow from the volcano's Ikoma crater was observed not in the infrared, but visible light spectrum. The reason is that like many other volcanoes where a similar phenomena has occurred, this glow was not from shallow magma, but rather one of the many volcanic gases which can burn hydrogen. While this gas often burns as a blue color if it has no impurities, even slight traces of various impurities can turn it other colors. In this case, it is quite likely that sodium impurities from the volcano turn the color of the flame to a shade of orange. While this does indicate an increased geothermal temperature at the volcano, it does not indicate that an eruption is imminent. However, people are still advised not to descend to the bottom of or go within any of this volcano's craters. Here is a quick list of all of the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on February 18th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Dimitar for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.